Good day, students. In this group, we're going to be going over an easy trick or method for multiply matrices. And don't forget to go to mathgotserved.com to see a wide collection of great math tutorials. All right, let's take a look at the first example. Problem number one. Let's say we were to find the product of these two matrices, 2, 1. 4, 5 multiplied by 3, 2, 5, 1. Okay, let's say we were to find the product of these two matrices. Of course, the product of matrices are not always defined. So first of all, we have to determine if the product is defined. That can be done by looking at the dimension of our matrices. This has two rows and two columns, so this is a 2 by 2. Well, let me write this on the bottom. So this is a 2 by 2 matrix, and this matrix right here is a 2 by 2 matrix. Now, how do we know if the product is defined? What we do is we look at the column of the first of the we could call this the multiplier matrix, multiplier. And then we can call this the multiplicand matrix, okay? All right, so we look at the column of the multiplier matrix and the row of the multiplicand matrix, and we'll ask ourselves, are these two numbers the same? Is this number and this number, are they the same? And the answer is yes, so since they're equal, then we can multiply them, okay? The product is defined. What is the dimension of the product going to be? To determine that, you look at the row of the multiplier matrix and the column of the multiplicand matrix, and that will be the dimension of our product. So we should expect to get a 2 by 2 matrix as the final result. All right. Now, since we've determined that the product of these two matrices is defined, let's go ahead and use the trick I was going to show you. So why is it important? Why am I doing this tutorial or showing you this trick? Well, multiplying matrices is not that difficult, but the process could get cluttered, okay? And when you have clutter in your workspace, it's very easy to make little arithmetic errors which throws up your answers. Or if you have, if you're dyslexic, you could start to invert numbers and make silly mistakes. So this is definitely a pain. That's why I want to show you this method, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to basically set up your product in such a way that it's very difficult to make mistakes. What we're doing is basically setting ourselves up for success, okay? So I'm going to take the way that you multiply matrix, let me go over that first before I show you how to do this, is you multiply the row in the multiply matrix by the column of the multiplicand matrix, okay? You multiply it like this, and then you do that, and then you do this, and then you go to the bottom, and then that, and then bottom, and then this again. You keep doing row times column, and that's how you get your answer. So that rotation back and forth between rows and columns in the multiplier matrix and the multiplicand matrix leaves a lot of room for mistakes in disorganization, okay? So that's why I want to show you this cool trick. So just remember that you multiply the rows of the first of multiply matrix with the column of the multiplicand of the second matrix, okay? Now, with that in mind, let me show you how I'm gonna set this up. What you do is you take the rows in the multiplier matrix and write them as coordinates, okay? This is a 2 by 2, so let's write it as a two-dimensional coordinates, 2 by 2, so it's 2, 4 for the first row, 2, 4, and then for the second row, 1, 5. So in two dimensions, you can think of this as x, y, all right? Now this is the cool part. We're going to write down the columns in the multiplicand matrix in a horizontal orientation, all right? So 3, 2 is a column in the second matrix right here. So I'll write it as 3, 2. All right, and then 5, 1, I'm going to orient it in a horizontal fashion, 5, 1. All right, so let's go over this again. The multiplier rows, the rows in the multiplier matrix, you write them just as is, but the columns in the multiplicand matrix, the second matrix you're multiplying by, you just orient them horizontally. Okay. Right, now that we have it set up like this, is a piece of cake. From here on out. So what we're going to do is basically multiply the numbers by multiplying corresponding coordinates. Okay, so x's times x, y times y, and you find the sum of the products. Okay, so for this coordinate and that coordinate, that's going to go into the first entry. 2 times 3 is 6, plus 4 times 2, 8. Okay, plus 6 plus 8, 14. So that's the first entry in our resultant matrix. And then the next one, you go 1 times 3, 3 plus 5 times 2, 10. 3 plus 10, 13. Next one, 2 times 5, you multiply the x's, 10 plus the y's, 4 times 1, 4, add it up, 14. Okay? And then the next one, we have 1 times 5, 5 plus 1 times 5, 5, add them together. You get 10. So your final matrix, the product of those two matrices, is 14, 14, 13, and 10. All right, so there you have it. All right, let's take a look at another example just to make sure we have this down. Problem number 2. So let's find the product of the following matrix, 2, 3, 1, 5. Find this times 1, 2, 2, 5, and then 3, 2. Okay, now, first of all, we don't just blindly multiply, we have to determine if the product is defined. So let's go ahead and determine that real quick. This is a 2x2 matrix, and this has two rows and three columns, 2x3. The column from the multiplier matrix is equal to the row of the multiplicand matrix. So that's excellent. So that means that we can multiply these two matrices. All right. And the answer for our product is going to be a 2x3 matrix. So we can keep that in mind. So since the product is defined, let's go ahead and find the product. Okay? Now let's set up our grid like we did before. We have two rows for the X, for the multiplier matrix. And then for the multiplicand matrix, we have three columns, so we're gonna make it sufficiently long to compensate for that size. All right, so for our multiplier matrix, we're copying the rows down as is, write it as coordinates 2, comma 1, and then we'll write down the row, the second row in the multiplier matrix, which is 3, comma 5. And then now we're gonna copy down the columns in the multiplicand matrix, okay? So don't forget this is the multiplier matrix, multiplier, and then this is the multiplicand. Now you might wonder why am I labeling them multiplier and multiplicand. The idea here is that multiplication of matrices does not commute. So A times B, matrix A times matrix B is not equal to matrix B times matrix A. So you have to be really careful with the order here. All right, so that's why I'm distinguishing them by their titles. Okay, so now let's copy down the columns of the multiplicand matrix. They are oriented vertically, but we're going to reorient them in a horizontal fashion. All right, so we have, what do we have here? 1, comma 2, write this column horizontally, and then 2, comma 5, and then lastly 3, comma 2. Now let's go ahead and multiply. We're going to have, we'll multiply the x's and the y's for each intersection. So these two intersect here, 2 times 1, 2, plus 2 times, I mean 1 times 2, 2. Answer equals 4. I hope you see how they are intersecting here, because this one And this one, they meet right here. So that's the 1 point plus 1 comma 1 spot. So that's how I'm doing it. Now the next set, this times this goes down here. It's just like a typical multiplication grid, right? So 3 times 1 is 3, plus 5 times 2 is 10. Sum, 13. Next one, 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 times 5 is 5. 4 plus 5 is 9. 2 times 3, 6, plus 5 times 5, almost root 10. 5 times 5 is 25. Sum is 31. And then last column, 3 times 2, 6. Plus 1 times 2, 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. And then 3 times 3 is 9. Plus 5 times 2, 10, which is equal to 19. So the beauty is the multiplication and addition, they're all organized in this setup. Okay, everything is inbuilt in the setup, so it's hard to make mistakes, basically. All right, so that's the beauty of this method. All right, so let's go ahead and write down what our resulting product is. It's going to be 4, 9, 8, and then 13, 31, 19. Okay, so that's an easy way to multiply matrices. So I'd like to thank you so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Please subscribe to our channel for updates and access to other cool clips such as this. And please post a comment to let us know what you think about this presentation. We really appreciate it. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.